Here's a beautiful object from the Powerhouse Museum's collection. Not everybody would see it as beautiful, and indeed, I wasn't convinced when I first found it on our shelves, but I've come to regard it now as one of my favourites. It's a small portion of the first transatlantic telegraph cable. It was connected in 1858 to establish the first instantaneous communication system between the two continents of Europe and America. It ran from Valencia Bay in Ireland to Heart's Content, Trinity Bay in Newfoundland. The idea that you could run a cable between England and America just seemed too fanciful. 2,000 odd miles it would need to cover, and it was regarded as science fiction, if you like. But there was a man by the name of Cyrus Fields, a very wealthy man, wealthy enough to retire at the age of 33, who decided when he heard about the telegraph that that would be his aim, would be to run this system around the world. They went to the middle of the Atlantic, and they had two ships, and they joined the two sections of the cable in the middle of the Atlantic, and each ship went in the opposite direction. This was a way of saving time. They started in 1857, and in August 1858, they actually managed to get a connection between Ireland and Newfoundland, and therefore London and New York. There was much rejoicing. In fact, people were almost hysterical about this idea that the two continents were now joined. Some said it was the greatest achievement of that particular century. The Tiffany Jewellery Company bought up all of the remaining cable and made it into little souvenir pieces, of which we actually have several. So it's not a rare item, but it's a lovely item. Of all of the pieces that we have, this is in the most splendid condition. It's actually has a little box which says that it's the original transatlantic cable, 1858, guaranteed by Tiffany and Company. It has a little collar on there with explaining what it is. And it also comes with a letter signed by Cyrus Field, authenticating that it's part of the original cable. Regrettably, despite the fact that the Queen Victoria was able to send a message to President Buchanan, and a few other messages were able to be sent and received, it wasn't very reliable, and just over a month after the cable was put in place, the whole thing stopped. This cable was rather too narrow across its diameter, and it ran under high voltage, which was a terrible mistake. Cyrus Field, fortunately, was able to raise enough money to start again. He got the fellow by the name of William Thompson. He specified the right sort of cable for the job and specified the right sort of galvanometer to detect the signal at the other end. And Thompson's cable was eventually connected on the 27th of July, 1866. And from that day forth, there was instantaneous communication between the two continents. We marvel today at our ability to communicate with words, pictures, videos across continents instantaneously, but I suspect that when the telegraph was introduced, it was an even more spectacular and magical thing for people who had been used to messages travelling no faster than the person that was carrying them. It elicited a lot of rhetoric about the possibilities, and it's actually the same things we hear today about our technologies. Its capacity for developing communities, its capacity for ensuring peace. I think an understanding of the way in which the telegraph developed gives us incredible insights into what's happening today. There are certainly strong echoes in our little piece of cable.